There are only three reasons anyone is ever broke, and today I'm gonna break them down for you and show you how to get out of being broke forever. Honestly, I was broke for most of my 20s. In fact, for a long time, I was spending more than I was making, and I was really digging myself into credit card debt. It was not cool. But I climbed out, and now looking back, I'm able to see what caused the problem. I can also see what helped me get out of it. Now, if you're living paycheck to paycheck, or you're constantly broke, you're struggling to stay above water, and you're ready to start living differently, this video is for you. My name is Brandon Turner, host of the BiggerPockets podcast and author of a bunch of real estate books. And in this video, I wanna share with you the solution to being broke forever. And hey, if you find this video helpful, please do me a favor, click that little thumbs up button below the video. It really honestly helps us stand out. These videos reach more people. All right, now, being broke has three possible causes. Not four, not two, three. And in all reality, it's probably caused by a combination of them. So I'm gonna discuss each cause one at a time. Let's get started. Number one, not enough income. Obvious, right? Well, let's talk about it. Several years ago in my late 20s, a close friend told me how much money he had made that year, and I was blown away. I thought, how can someone in their 20s be making so much? But then a couple of years later, I actually made that almost exactly the same amount. In like 2 years, my income more than quadrupled in that time. How? Well, I'm a 100% believer in the principle that you are the average of the five closest friends or associates you hang out with. Now, I didn't make all that money from real estate. Some was from cash flow, some from flipping, some from selling books, some from other random side projects. But I attribute a lot of it to my friend just telling me how much he made. Here's why. Everyone has an internal thermostat that defines how much money they should earn. When they earn more than what their thermostat's set at, they subconsciously decrease their efforts. When they slip below it, they hustle, or subconsciously, or otherwise, make up for that difference. So when my friend told me that he made a good chunk of money, my thermostat rose to his level. Now, if you really want a mind-blowing thought, at least I thought so, Brian Tracy, author of the book The Psychology of Selling, says that that internal thermostat is set by how much money your father makes. Mind blown. My internal thermostat had been set by my dad's income, and I had no idea. It wasn't until I recognized that internal limitation that things began to change. Of course, getting more income is not as easy as just turning up a thermostat. You still have to do the work, right? Now, when talking about making more money, we have to differentiate between two types of people. Some people have the ability to earn more money by working harder or smarter. For example, a real estate agent or a salesperson or a small business owner. Others, though, get paid at certain times a certain amount because that's just what they get paid. Like teachers, firefighters, police officers. So let me speak to those careers without an income cap first. Let's say you're a real estate agent and you want to start investing in real estate. It helps to have a lot of income when you're going into a real estate deal. And by the way, if you're currently broke, I wouldn't actually recommend you start investing in real estate quite yet. Instead, I'd probably encourage you to get unbroke by focusing on the agent side of things. After all, think about it. Is it easier to start generating an extra grand a month from a brand new thing you've never done before or something you've already been doing for a while? All right, so to continue this real estate agent example, how can a real estate agent increase their current income? Well, here's a few ideas. Read every book on becoming a real successful real estate agent. Or wake up at 4 a.m. every day to work on personal development skills. Or take other successful agents out to lunch and find out how they did it. Or find a daily process that'll help you increase your real estate sales within the next 6 months. Maybe that means making 100 cold calls every day. Maybe it means spending 5 hours a day door knocking. Whatever it is, find the process, stick to it. The results will take care of themselves. Forget small goals like, I'm gonna increase my commissions by 10%. Instead, think, how can I quadruple my sales volume this year? Bigger questions lead to bigger results. Now, of course, this was an example just for real estate agents, but what if your job doesn't allow you to make more money? Maybe you're a stockbroker, a fisherman, an insurance agent, a high school teacher. If you want to earn more income, you will likely have to look outside your job to discover ways that you can add value to the world. Yeah, value to the world. That's how you make money. So maybe you're a math teacher and you make 50 grand a year, but you have no ability to earn more money. That's it, 50 grand. So what skills can you provide to the world that people may pay for? How about tutoring? Could you create a math tutoring program that helps kids improve their math skills? Or maybe you can create a simple online course that teaches math concepts. Or maybe you'll do something that has nothing to do with math at all, but involves something else that you're passionate about, like starting a roofing business or a carpet business on the side.
But Brandon, I don't know how to lay carpet.
Gee, you're right. Man, if only there was like an online website that had billions of videos that explained how to do everything in the world and it was completely free. You could watch it on your phone anytime. Well, too bad there isn't that. So I'm gonna go watch some Game of Thrones. I think it starts soon. Kidding aside, the point is there are always ways to make more money. In fact, making money is a skill that anyone can master, but few do. Everyone has an excuse for why they can't make more money, but those excuses generally boil down to one thing. Laziness. Or maybe an unwillingness to learn, which is kind of the same. I'm not saying that everyone is lazy, but they are lazy when it comes to learning how to make money. So get out there, start reading books on how to make money, watch YouTube videos, intern under somebody, start practicing just like any skill. The more you learn, the more you practice, the better you'll become. However, all that said, earning enough money is rarely the problem. Yeah, that's correct. Most likely you already earn enough money right now. The problem is how much you spend. That brings us to the second reason people are broke. They spend too much money. You know, when people say that they're really broke, I tend to wonder which of the following they currently pay for. And I don't mean to judge. We all pay for things that we want, right? But these things tend to add up. Car payments, Netflix, Hulu memberships, magazine subscriptions, eating out at restaurants more than once a month. Pre-packaged food? Yeah, cook your own meals, you'll save a bunch of money. New clothing, right? Bottled water? Smartphone and data plans. Vacations? Cable TV. Again, not all these expenses are inherently bad, but many people I know who are super broke spend their money on not just one or two of these, but all of them. They could likely cut out a number of them and save hundreds, if not thousands of dollars every month.
Brandon, you complain. You can't seriously be telling me to get rid of my iPhone. I need it.
Yeah. If you're broke, you have no business owning an iPhone. I said it. That is, unless you don't mind being broke. So stop complaining about being broke or get rid of your phone. Go get a dumb phone, one of those things that opens up. All right. Some people say, well, I'm way more productive with my iPhone. No, you're not. That's besides the point. But you're not more productive. You'd be much more productive with a team of 200 personal assistants, but you can't afford them. And you can't afford a fancy phone either. And it's not just fancy phones, it's everything. Take a look at a couple more common and expensive monthly payments. Car loans, house payments.
But I need a nice car to get to work. I don't want a junker car, I'm gonna have to fix that. So that's why I have this big, huge, gigantic car payment.
So the problem with that thinking though, is that it assumes that there's only two options. Buy a crap junker car, or buy a brand new car and have a car loan. A person can definitely get a car for $3,000 that's not gonna break down every month. And if you do have to fix stuff, I can almost guarantee you it'll be cheaper than the $400 or $500 or $600 a month car payment that most people carry around. The same applies for house payments.
But my wife, my kids deserve to live in a nice place. I don't want them to get shot.
Okay, I'm sure you do feel that they deserve nice stuff, but again, there's a middle ground. I'm not suggesting that a person goes and lives in an unsafe neighborhood where their family might get murdered for crossing the street. I'm suggesting that there are a lot of nice blue-collar neighborhoods where a person could rent. It's true. I actually don't believe everyone should own their home, especially when it's cheaper to rent. You know, in my early 20s, I realized I had a major spending problem. So I went and lived in a church parsonage, you know, that little house next door to where a church lives, for free in exchange for doing the labor on fixing the place up. Yeah, it was a sacrifice. I lived in a weird little house out in the woods next to a church. But the year I spent there helped me stabilize my life and build a more financially secure foundation. Did my wife deserve a better place to live with air conditioning and a garage? Yeah, and I want to say that emotionally, but to be honest, we didn't deserve it yet because we didn't earn it yet. However, last year I bought my wife her dream home in Maui, Hawaii with the most incredible view I've ever seen because finally we've earned it. Now, let's move on to the third and most important reason people are broke. They don't manage their money correctly. In other words, poor money management skills. Understand that the reasons above, number one and number two, they can affect every person no matter what income levels they find themselves in. I know people who earn $300,000 or $400,000 a year who are just as broke as people I know earning $12,000 a year. Because it's not what you earn, nor what you spend, it's how you manage it. This is the primary reason I was so broke, because I didn't stop to manage my finances with the same degree of care that I was managing my rental properties. I just spent what I wanted with my magic debit card and let myself do whatever I wanted. That was a bad idea. Money has to be managed by you or it will rule over you, causing you to always play on the defense and live reactively. But good money management is about knowing what money is coming in, what money is going out and making sure that the latter is less than the former. Good money management is about knowing what you have spent money on so you can make informed decisions about what you should spend money on. It's about working with your spouse or significant other to establish boundaries and guidelines for how money should be spent. Now, I recommend three things to begin developing better money management. First, know where you are right now. Sit down, look at your finances over the past month or two, and place every expense into a category. How much do you spend on rent? How much do you spend dining out? What about car payments? How much income is coming in? Take a look at the past 3 months, really, to get an idea of where you mostly spend that money. I'd recommend using like mint.com. It's a great site for that task, and it's easier than a spreadsheet. And it's free, so that's a win. Secondly, establish a budget. Ooh, I know everyone talks about budgeting, and I know that you should have a budget, but do you actually have one? And more importantly, are you sticking with it? So set up weekly appointments with your significant other or with an accountability partner to go over your finances at least once a month, if not more. Make sure you keep yourself on track. And then third, automate your savings. Be sure to place a line item in your budget for saving part of your income. Even if you're just saving $5 a month, do it, and then increase it over time. Challenge yourself to see how high you can get. Don't rely on yourself to remember to set aside money for savings. You won't do it. Automate it, because most bank accounts give you the ability to set up automatic transfers to a savings account. Do that today, like right now. Oh wait, go. Now, once you have a firm handle on your money management, you can further improve your life by increasing your income or decreasing your spending. For example, if you're able to get on a budget and essentially break even, also known as living paycheck to paycheck, every extra dollar you make or save will help you reverse your broke status. So shut off your cable TV, take that 75 bucks a month, add it to your automatic savings. Downgrade to an old-fashioned 2004 style flip phone. Save that $50 a month and add it to your savings. Start driving for Uber in the evenings. Bring in another $50 a day doing that. Add that money to your savings. Do what you gotta do. So, are you ready to stop being broke? Are you ready to stop living paycheck to paycheck? Are you ready to stop stressing about paying your next bill? Then recognize that being broke is 100% your own fault, but also 100% within your ability to remedy it. So get to work on fixing it. Clean up your finances with better money management, decrease your spending with sacrifice, and start earning more through hustle. By effectively combining these three steps, you'll never be broke again. And hey, if you like this video, don't forget to click that little thumbs up button and subscribe to our channel. For BiggerPockets.com, my name is Brandon Turner, signing off.